new details into an 11 News Investigates exclusive, Hidden Danger. A Johns Hopkins University expert says treated water is not enough to protect people from lead water pipes across Baltimore City and county.
And as we've reported exclusively last month, city and county residents being asked now to check nearly 230,000 water pipes on their private property for lead.
Investigative reporter Tali Taylor joins us now live. Tali, DPW previously told you that treating the water with enough lime prevents all lead from getting into the water. So what are they talking about here?
And the Hopkins engineer and the EPA's top water official both tell me that's not quite accurate. They both agree that DPW's efforts at corrosion control are an important stepping stone, but they also point out that no amount of lead is safe in drinking water. And to completely stop the powerful neurotoxin from leaching into someone's home water supply, they say that you have to remove all the lead.
This is the room where it happens. These two white tanks at Ashburton's filtration plant are packed with lime. And as DPW's Paul Sayen explains, all of the water that comes through the plant comes into contact with this lime. So when the drinking water leaves the plant and heads into Baltimore City and county, it's in the best shape possible to prevent the lead in any pipes from leaching into the water. And if you saw 11 News Investigates' first story about this last month, you might remember this moment.
Are you concerned that you'll find a high number of lead service lines?
I wouldn't say concern's the right word. So we maintain the water chemistry so that lead pipe doesn't actually corrode.
And Sayen said it several more times throughout our interview.
The city maintains a water chemistry that prevents the lead pipe from corroding. If there is lead in the system, again, it's not a cause of panic because it won't corrode.
Sayen's right that it's not a reason for panic. If you discover that your home has lead pipes, that doesn't mean you have lead in your water. But two experts 11 News Investigates interviewed say corrosion control is not 100% effective.
Water sitting in pipes means that lead could leach into the water, especially if it's not moving quickly.
11 News Investigates met Hopkins environmental engineer Natalie Exum on North Washington Street near her office. One of the many neighborhoods that DPW's map shows is covered in blue dots, meaning the water pipes need to be checked for lead. Across Baltimore City and County, roughly 230,000 water pipes on private property need to be checked for lead.
You're saying that once it enters a private residence, if the water is sitting there, that's where even that lime can't necessarily help.
Right, and so that's true, right? We need to get smart about our drinking water and really think through what are the riskier times that we should not necessarily be drinking exactly what comes out of the faucet.
And then there's this unavoidable fact. Baltimore City Public Schools has a total of 139 schools, and 96 of them continue to use only bottled water because of lead in their drinking water. That's more than two-thirds of all city schools.
If there are issues with the water in schools, how could there not be issues in residences around Baltimore?
This is really important, and especially when we're talking about kids, because kids are more vulnerable to lead. That's a concern that if there is in the schools, that it may also be in our homes. And this is something that we're going to find out more about as this partnership rolls out.
Are you saying that you would not be surprised if there are a good number of lead pipes in there?
I would not be surprised.
The Biden administration and the US EPA have the same concern as Exum.
That's why President Biden has really set the national goal of removing all lead pipes from water systems.
11 News Investigates interviewed the EPA's top water official last month, the day the Biden administration announced a new rule called the Lead and Copper Rule Improvements. If approved, it would require that most cities nationwide remove 100% of their lead water pipes within 10 years.
Newark, New Jersey is a great example, had a significant lead issue.
Radhika Fox said cities like Newark, Green Bay, Wisconsin, and Benton Harbor, Michigan all had significant issues with lead pipes and are now models for fixing the issue. But corrosion control wasn't enough in those cities. And she says the new national rule about lead pipes makes that clear.
It sounds like the key wording is that while it is generally effective at reducing lead to low levels, the EPA says repeatedly there's no amount of lead that's safe in water. Is that right?
That's correct. I think it's important to remember that even when we remove lead pipes, there can be lead in the faucets and the fixtures in homes and businesses.
Those fixtures, those faucets, if they're present in a residence or business,
they can still contribute to lead leaching into the water, it sounds like.
Yes, this is the time to get the lead out of our water system.
And it's important to note, recent DPW water tests do not show elevated levels of lead. And earlier this week, I asked Mayor Brandon Scott where this lead pipe issue in the city and county ranks on his list of priorities for 2024. Here's what he said.
When the federal government tells you you have to do something, then it becomes a top issue, right? And we're doing this not just because they are telling us that we have to, but also it's the right thing to do. Quite frankly, it should have been done 30 years ago.
Now, DPW did not answer our repeated request for comment, asking how lead pipes could be affecting the water quality in schools when they say lead pipes do not affect the water quality in people's homes. DPW will host two public meetings in January to help teach people how to check their pipes for lead. You can find the full details on those meetings and how to look up your home address right now on the WBAL-TV app. For 11 News Investigates, I'm Tali Taylor.